In 1945, the UN formed an organization called UNESCO. The organization was created, in part, to preserve both natural and cultural heritage sites worldwide. Since its creation, more than 1,000 places have been added to its list. Out of all these places, only 3 have been removed. And one of these removals happened here, in Dresden, Germany. The process of becoming a heritage site is relatively straightforward. UNESCO operates with a list consisting of 10 criteria. Any candidate must fulfill at least one of them. Countries are free to nominate potential sites within their own borders, which they normally do through commissions. So in Germany, that would be the KMK, Kulturministerkonferenz. And it was this body that in 2003 nominated the Dresden Elbe Valley for the World Heritage List. Originally, they wanted to nominate the city's old town. However, it was made clear that such an application would not be approved by UNESCO, as the entire area had been destroyed during the Second World War, and thus it was no longer in its original state. The Elbe River bank, with many of its buildings, did however remain relatively untouched. Moreover, there was no shortage of impressive and culturally significant structures along it. Therefore, a redrawn application making up the Dresden Elbe Valley was the one that went on to be granted the World Heritage title in 2004. A title that was comically short-lived, as the city lost it just 5 years later. In June 2009, Dresden became the second heritage site to be stripped of its status, and it was all because of this, a bridge. Now, there's nothing wrong with the bridge itself. The Waldschlösschen Bridge looks like any other contemporary arch bridge. The problem is its location. At the beginning of the century, this site became the battleground for 2 advocacy groups. On one hand, you had the ones who wanted to preserve the Elbe Valley landscape. On the other, were people eager to improve the city's traffic. And they had been around for a long time. The first proposal for a bridge dates back to the late 1800s. The residents of the Johannstadt neighborhood wanted a pedestrian river crossing. Back then, the 2 nearest bridges were 4.5 kilometers apart, and residents either had to take a ferry or make a long detour to access the forest on the opposite side. Their proposal eventually reached the city council, who in turn rejected it because of aesthetic concerns. The idea of building another bridge, though, didn't die out, it just evolved. During the Nazi era, it went from a pedestrian crossing to being planned for vehicles. In the GDR, the plan grew even further, first by proposing a 6-lane bridge, and later an 8-lane one, with motorway junctions. What kept the project from being realized had little to do with aesthetics. Let's just say that neither regime had the finances. This would change in the 1990s as Germany became reunited. All of a sudden, East Germany experienced a capital influx, which in turn led to a significant increase in traffic volume. Bridge proponents capitalized on this, and in 1996, the city council decided to build the Waldschlösschen Brücke. But building a bridge takes time. First you have to plan it, and then obviously build it. By the time any construction could begin, a problem had arisen. The valley had been granted the World Heritage title by UNESCO. The title had been given because the organization believed 4 criteria had been fulfilled. Bridge opponents would go on to use these when arguing against the project. What's more, they feared that the city would lose its newfound World Heritage title if the project were to go through. A reasonable fear at the time, as UNESCO had expressed concerns about the project. Their pleas would, however, fall on deaf ears. A crucial argument for building another crossing was that it would alleviate the city's historic core from through traffic, a problem that had gotten significantly worse during the 90s. Equally, if not more important, was public perception. In 2005, a referendum was held where a clear majority voted in favor of a bridge. Concerned about the developments, UNESCO decided in 2006 to place the valley on its red list, a list of threatened sites. This sparked a new debate about the possibility of building a tunnel instead. with the exception being pedestrians, ironically, the tunnel would be a better solution for everyone, it was argued. But, with a plan already made and a referendum supporting it, construction of the bridge began in 2007. 2 years later, UNESCO removed the valley's title, and the bridge was opened in 2012. So what effect did this decision have? For UNESCO, it is obvious that should the World Heritage title have any value, the organization must keep its integrity. What is not so obvious is where to draw the line. Remember I told you that any heritage site must fulfill at least 1 out of 10 criteria? Well, in Dresden's case, it was 4. And while the bridge certainly interfered with some of them, it is not clear that it did to all. Quote,
"The Dresden Elbe Valley contains outstanding evidence of courtly architecture and festivity, as well as well-known examples of civic architecture and an industrial heritage that represents European urban development into the industrial era." End quote.
Now, the buildings are still standing. The only change is the addition of a bridge. This begs the question, could Dresden have kept the title? Even though one could perhaps argue for it, it is difficult to see how it would benefit UNESCO. Making significant changes to a World Heritage Site goes against the idea of preserving it. Furthermore, the city was given a warning that they chose to ignore. By removing the title, UNESCO kept its integrity and set a precedent for future cases, one that was also used when Liverpool went on to lose its title in 2021. As for Dresden, the decision to build a bridge may not only have cost them one, but 2 World Heritage titles. On its northern border, you find Hellerau, Germany's first garden city, which I will make a video about later. Currently, the Free State of Saxony is proposing for it to be added to UNESCO's list. It is, however, believed that given Dresden's past, it will be an uphill battle to convince the organization to once more grant the city a World Heritage title.